Come on, Kean, pack up.
But what is it, a transfer?
In a way. Well, don't just sit there. Pack.
Well, couldn't you at least tell me where I'm going? I was hoping to stay with my daughter.
Oh, you can forget that. It's not likely bail's going to come through for this one.
Bail?
You're on your way out. Mum, say goodbye. Get a blanket, quick. Oh, don't tell me this is...
Take your clothes off.
Take my clothes off?
What are you talking
about?
There was a chance that your job could have been saved.
I didn't think there was any hope. I wanted to do something worthwhile before I left.
Worthwhile?
I wanted to get rid of Joan Ferguson. Once and for all. Everyone knows she's been. Nobody can prove it.
I did understand your bitterness. But for you to have even considered this course of action is unforgivable. I have no option now but to dismiss you. Collect your things and leave the premises immediately.
Meg! Why?
That's enough out of you.
You bastard!
Easy!
Somebody found out about us, did they?
I said that's enough.
Are you all right?
No.
I'm afraid this is only the beginning. His whole defence is going to be based on an alleged prior association.
You what, mate?
Yeah, just I saw a man leaving Meg's flat the night before.
I think it was him.
Sure you don't want one? Look, I'll put a kettle on for you. Or are you just going to sit there and watch me drink?
I am not a child, Philip. I'm perfectly capable of putting the kettle on for myself.
I'm sure you are. Meg, you've spoken about 5 words since we left the police station.
I don't believe this. I really don't believe it. I mean, you tell the police in a loud, clear voice that you saw Wright leaving here, which makes it perfectly plain for any fool to see that you believe his story.
For God's sake, is that what you think?
And then you have the nerve to wonder why I'm upset.
It occurred to me that he was obviously about to break in when I arrived. If I'd arrived a few minutes later, I probably would have caught him red-handed.
Oh, I see. And why didn't you bother to tell that to the police?
If I thought for a moment that they doubted your word, I would have. Meg, I know how you feel.
Oh, for God's sake, don't be so absurd.
All right, then. I sympathize deeply.
But you still think I was asking for it. Oh, you're the same as the rest of them.
Now you're being absurd.
Am I?
Meg, I want to help you. Help you get over it. But if you insist on blaming all men for what's happened to you, I can't.
Well, perhaps that's what I am doing. I don't know. All I know is that I'm angry and I'm confused and I don't know who to trust.
You could try trusting me. Maybe I better go. Okay. Good night.
Really thought we had her this time.
Well, that lovely Miss Rogers gets the sack and Miss Ferguson stays. It's just not fair.
Just ran into Mrs. Barry. She reckons Bucky's already gone.
Oh, it's the same every time. As soon as we get a good screw, the freak sticks her oar in and we lose them.
But Miss Rogers would still be here if it hadn't been for us.
She did go along with it, Pix.
It was a good plan. It should have worked.
Yeah, the only thing we didn't count on was human error.
Mm. I wonder what scheme that bitch is going to come up with to get back at us now.
Oh, I wish I was sharing my dorm with someone. She might come in and get me during the night.
Now, that is not going to happen.
Well, hell, I'll be packing it.
Yeah.
Oh.
You've got a big mouth.
Sorry.
Anyway, Mrs. Reynolds will be watching her like a hawk. She'd be crazy to try anything.
Oh, I hope you're right.
Well, you came close this time, didn't you, Desmond? Pity Rogers was such an incompetent. But then I could have told you that. Oh, stupid us. We should have thought to ask you. You've done it now. You know that, don't you? Won't be able to go running off to the governor anymore. There'll be no point in blaming Miss Ferguson now, ladies.
I wouldn't get too cozy, Miss Ferguson. We'll just wait till you make another mistake.
But you're wrong, Desmond. I don't make mistakes. And even if I did, who do you think would believe you now? So you're going to have to be very, very careful. And that goes for the lot of you. You've tried my patience just a little too far. Good night.
Oh, good night, Governor.
Good night. Joan, I'm afraid we'll have to forget what I said about cancelling visiting privileges.
Why?
I've just remembered that Mitchell's father's coming tomorrow. I think we'd do more harm than good if we stopped that. So would you tell her? And Warren too. Otherwise it'll look like favouritism.
Do we have to? I think we lose face when we
forget
back down.
Forget it. I'll do it myself.
Edie, I'm home.
Hello, dear. How was your day?
Oh, not bad, not bad.
What's in the bag?
Oh, just a few seedlings.
Oh, I shouldn't have thought there was room for anything else in that garden of yours.
Oh, they're not mine, love. They're for the ladies at Wentworth.
My Stan, do you ever stop thinking of others?
Ah, something smells good.
I'm making a celebratory dinner. First day back from work and all that.
Oh, Edie, there's no need for that.
Don't be silly. Of course there is. Now, why don't you go and change and... then you can come and tell me all about your first day back at work, and I want to know everything, mind. Are you feeling all right?
Yes, yes. Just a bit tired, that's all.
Stan, you sure you feel up to going back to work again?
Never felt more sure of anything in my life. I'll go and change.
There are no excuses, Killy. I asked you to do something and you didn't do it.
It wasn't my fault.
I don't like it when people let me down, especially scum like you.
Look, what difference does it make? Things turned out the same in here.
Yes, but they mightn't have.
Well, what was I supposed to do? She had a bloody knife.
Kean?
That's what I've been trying to tell you. It looked sharp, and I didn't feel like letting her use it on me.
Where do you think she got that?
Kitchen, I suppose. So you better do something about it before she sticks one of us, hadn't you?
Don't tell me you're scared of a has-been like Kean.
You're not the one that shares a cell with her.
True. So it's not my problem, is it?
But aren't you going to help me get the knife off her?
Why should I?
Because I'm not going to be much bloody use to you if she cuts my flame and throat.
Then you get it. And I don't think that Kean's got the guts to use it. You see, it's that nice, refined background of hers. Don't worry, Kelly. You see, I'll get Kean one way or another. With or without your help. But I can count on you, can't I?
I hope you don't mind me just dropping in like this.
No, no, of course not. Sit down.
I thought we might be able to settle each other down. I'm as jumpy as a cat sitting at home alone.
But I thought they'd put a policeman outside again.
Oh, they did, but it doesn't make much difference. I can't see myself relaxing at all until they find that letter writer.
Brandy?
Oh, yes, please. What happened at the lineup?
Well, I suppose you could say it was a success. His name's Wright. Peter Wright. I haven't found the other one yet.
Did he confess?
He called me by name. Told them we were having an affair.
God. He'll never make them believe it, Meg. What about taking a couple of weeks off? Might help you get your mind off the whole thing, at least to some extent.
Oh, wish it were that easy.
You've got leave owing to you.
I know.
Then take it.
Still have to come back.
Not till you're ready.
Going away won't make the problem go away. I mean, I still have to learn how to feel safe in here again.
Yes, well, could be a while till that happens.
And what if it doesn't? What then?
Is what you're looking for? Oh, yeah, it's sharp. There's one thing these walls are good for. It's putting an edge on a blade.
Wasn't my idea. The freak told me to get it.
And she just guessed I had it, that right? Still think I'm losing my sting, Kelly.
You'd rather work for me, wouldn't you, Kelly?
Yeah, sure. Of course I would, Rep.
You could be a sort of a double agent.
Pretend you're dealing with a freak and let me know everything she's up to.
Cut it out, will you? You're making me nervous. I'm with you, Rep, honest. Anything you say.
That's all I wanted to hear. Oh, Kelly.
Yeah?
This discussion goes no further, right?
Yeah, right.
Bloody Superman!
If only Never got the bloody job, we'd be up to our knees in dope plants in a couple of months.
Can't see your problem. Dobson will know a dope plant from a hole in the ground.
You reckon? Hey, it should be easy enough to get some seeds in, too.
Take too long. Now a bloke will have some plants.
Yeah, but how are we going to get him past the gates?
Shouldn't be too difficult. See what I can do.
Good one. God will make a fortune.
Where the bloody hell is Bobbie?
Not still with the skip. I'm running out of things to watch.
So, don't complain.
Here's trouble.
Oh. Pay attention. The governor wants to speak to you.
Mrs. Reynolds, about visits. It doesn't matter so much to me, but Bobby's meeting a little sister.
Yes,
first...
Warren, you'll be able to have visitors, but you won't be able to accept any gifts from them.
Oh, jeez. Thanks, Mrs. Reynolds.
Also, you will not be presenting the cheque to the deaf children as planned.
Oh, come on.
You're getting
oh,
off
no.
very lightly. See the women get back to work, would you?
Could I have a word, Mrs. Reynolds? In private, it's important.
Sure. Not fair.
Stand the man. How's it going?
Hello, Bobbie. Oh, not badly. How are you?
Oh, not so good. I thought you would have heard about all that.
I did hear that at a time, dear sentence.
Yeah, 6 lousy months. They sent Cass to an...
I know. I was very distressed to hear about that. How did it happen?
Well, I got preggers. It's a long story. Anyway, Cass got really excited. She was making me give up smoking and drink milk tea. She was driving me around the bend. Then I had the accident and I lost the kid.
Oh, Bobbie. I am sorry.
Yeah, well, Cass just sort of went downhill from then on. Sometimes I don't even reckon there's any point in me living anymore.
No, you mustn't talk like that. There's always something to look forward to.
I'm always going to be a loser, Stan. Nothing's ever going to go right for me.
Now, you listen. I felt the same way a few days ago. I felt like just giving up.
Come on.
No, I've been feeling that way quite a bit since I retired. Then I got this job.
But it's different for you. You got Edie and Marianne. I've got no one to fall back on.
Well, Mrs. Reynolds did say your father was coming to visit you.
Him. Still, I suppose I am looking forward to seeing my little sister.
There you are, you see. Always something to look forward to.
You know, Cass was the only mate I ever had that was like real family to me. Anyway, reckon I'd bust out again if it meant I could see her.
What, and have another year added to your sentence?
Doesn't make any difference now.
How about I go and see Cass for you?
Yeah?
As long as you promise not to do anything stupid.
Oh, I reckon... You know something, Stan? You're one of the best. Anyway, I reckon I should go now. I'll see you later, okay?
Bye. So, now I'd like to have power of attorney transferred to Mum. I'm told I can still do that, seeing she hasn't been tried yet.
Yes, that's right.
Yeah, well, she'll need some money, cover legal costs, that sort of thing. I owe the old lady a favour or two.
I hope you're prepared for the fact that she could be found guilty.
Not if I tell the court that I threatened to kill her. She didn't help me. They'll believe her, they'll have to.
I hope so, if that's the way it really happened. Would you arrange for Kean to phone as a solicitor, Mrs. Barry?
Yes, of course. Come along, Kean. There is another call I'd like to make, Mrs. Reynolds, to an old friend. Ask him to keep an eye on my mother. Make sure she's okay.
All right. It's good to see you taking an interest in someone else's welfare, Kean.
I guess I owe you an apology.
You don't owe me a thing.
Oh, come on, don't be so damn understanding.
As you wish. What do you want to apologize for?
Well, for the way I've been treating you. You were right. I was blaming you for something another man did.
A very natural reaction.
Yeah, but pretty childish, so forgive me.
Look, as far as I'm concerned, there's nothing to forgive, but if it makes you happy, yes, I do. Make you a coffee?
Yeah, thanks.
Anne tells me to put in to do as much night duty as possible.
Yes, I still don't feel very comfortable at night on my own.
Don't you have a sympathetic friend or sister you could get to come and stay with you?
Oh, it's a bit much to ask of anyone. I'll be right. What worries me more is something Angela Adams said yesterday. It was strange. It was almost as if she knew that I'd been raped.
Look, there isn't any way that any of the women could know, is there?
Oh, I don't know. Maybe I'm just reading things into everything anyone says or does. I'd hate it if the women did know.
Meg, this isn't some guilty secret you've got. You were brutally attacked. The same thing has happened to thousands of women.
I know.
You have every right to feel angry, but not ashamed, for God's sake.
Well, I do feel ashamed. I feel ashamed and I feel dirty. I can't help it.
Did you notice the look on Marlene's face when she went off to see her folks?
Yeah.
Wouldn't it be lovely to have a family as close as Marlene's?
Yeah, it sure would.
God, that makes me sick. How'd you go?
Half as a dozen 6-inch plants, so...
Bloody terrific. When do we get them?
Soon. We just have to shove them in amongst the other plants. Hope Dobson doesn't notice.
Yeah, be a lot less risky if we didn't have to worry about the old bastard, though. Listen, if we could just get Nev into the job, he'd help us set up all sorts of rackets. No telling what sort of stuff he could smuggle in. If we could just get rid of old Dobson, we'd be home and hosed.
Yeah. Come to think of it, that dryer he fixed yesterday looks like breaking down again.
Not much of a handyman, is he?
Gotcha.
Well, that's all.
Don't. Oh, here she is. Come and say good day to me mum and dad. Oh. This is Bobbie.
Pleased to meet you, Bobbie. Sounds like you've been a real mate to young Marlene.
Oh, that's not what she says sometimes.
Oh, Bobbie, yeah, reckons off. That you two girls are going to flat together when you get out.
Oh, yeah, if I ever get out. Rabbit, do you mind? Oh, sorry. What an idiot.
That's a dead little sister. She's never seen one of those sisters.
G'day. Good to see you, Bobbie. Guess we've got a bit of catching up to do, eh?
Yeah. G'day, Cheryl.
Told you I lost my job, did I?
A couple of times, yeah.
Don't know how they expect anyone to live on the dole, let alone support a kid.
She looks as if you're taking care of her all right.
Sure, but only because I live on bread and water, so she'll get enough.
Well, there's bugger all I can do about that.
You could stay out of bloody trouble. That'd be a start. The rate you're going, you'll never get out of here.
The last time you saw me, you said you didn't care if you never saw me again.
Yeah, well, now I want you back home, so just keep your flaming nose clean for a change.
Oh, this is ridiculous. I'll see you later, kid, all right?
Hey, just remember, you get yourself out of here and come back and start earning a bloody living for us. It's about time you've done something to repay what I've done for you.
That's a joke. All you ever done was lay around drunk.
Shut your mouth, slut. You call yourself a father.
Mum.
She was a stupid bitch too.
Right, it's time for you to go, Mr. Mitchell.
Like us to show him out for you, Mrs. Barry.
I'll have you up for assault if you don't take your bloody hands off me.
Right, out, now.
They'll have to let you out of here sometime, sweetheart. And old Dad will be waiting for you when they do.
I'm sorry, Bobbie.
Oh, why don't you shut your mouth?
Well, if the women are as enthusiastic as they were last time, we should be eating our own produce in a couple of months.
Aubergines, asparagus, very impressive.
Mind you, if I have my way, I'd have more of the carrots and cauliflowers and less of this aubergines business. These chefs have some funny ideas sometimes.
Well, the women certainly approve of Ray's cooking.
Oh, and so do the officers.
I know, so I'm prepared to go along with it.
Mrs. Reynolds, I've been looking for you. I found these on the floor outside the rec room.
Is it a complete set?
Well, no, so I'm not sure who they belong to.
My heavens. Mrs. Reynolds, I feel terrible. I must have dropped them. I don't know
well,
how.
Well, let's just hope there's no harm done this time. Be more careful, all right?
Yes, yes, of course. But I would have heard them if they'd dropped. I don't know how it could have happened.
Couldn't believe it when he just up and whacked her across the face like that. What a pig!
Yeah, poor kid. No wonder she didn't want to see him.
Bastards like that should be drowned at birth. How is she anyway?
Just wants to be by herself for a while. What's that, Jude?
It's a letter from my daughter. She just wanted to congratulate everyone on setting the new world record.
Oh, isn't that nice? Yeah. I wish we could have handed over the check ourselves, but... Oh, quick, quick, look at this gorgeous new compact.
Can I read that to us?
No, it's just family stuff. I don't think it'd interest you.
Pixie, it's a bloody so commercial. It's pretty cute, but... Hey, listen, you two, I've been thinking, why don't we try another world record?
Oh, are you ever going to give up?
What? Look, if you do, how about something non-physical next time, like lying in bed?
Oh, you piker. Look, if we thought about it, we could think of something easy and fun, like standing on your head.
What?
And what's the world record for that?
I don't know, it'd be just a few hours.
Oh, my God.
You couldn't stand on your head for 10 minutes, Warren.
I bet I could.
50 cents says you can't.
Oh, yeah, well, I reckon I can, but I don't know about putting money on it.
She can.
I bet can. Marlene can do it. 50 cents says she can.
Yeah. Okay, ladies, who's going to place their bets to see if Marlene can stand on her head for 10 minutes?
Come on, where's your sense of adventure? You'll make some money out of it.
Okay,
come on.
Over there by the counter, you can lean on it.
Up count, okay?
Come on.
Here we go, girls.
Okay. Okay.
And elephant one. Elephant two. Elephant four. Elephant five.
Shove off, will you?
They just came by to say I'm sorry.
You're full of crap, Cleary. Get out. I should never let you suck me in like you did.
Come off her, Bobby. You got to meet Cheryl,
she's
didn't you?
Didn't
she
count for anything? Now get out! Will you rack off?
Come on.
It's never been all right to be bloody scrambled now.
Shut up, Lou. She's nearly there. It must be.
Oh, here we go.
Hey.
There, go. It can be very bad for you standing on your head like that.
Only when people bloody push you over.
Did you hurt yourself?
Not much, Miss Ferguson.
What a shame. I thought you might have broken something.
How much more of this do you think you can get away with?
How much more of what? A job for you.
Your knee's okay, honey.
Bitch, I could have done it for 2 hours.
But you did do it. You got the 10 minutes. You won your money.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh,
come on.
I
don't
said I couldn't do it. Come on.
Oh,
listen, what do you think
it
was up to?
I don't know, but I sure as hell wish I did.
I looked at his keys. So what? Did he use them or make copies or nothing?
You leave the old man alone or you will have me to answer to.
Yeah, all right. So what's the job you got for me?
Does Kean always carry that knife?
Yeah. It's not going to sell anyway.
Right. I want you to cause a bit of a stir in the garden this afternoon. Make it look as though she started it.
So she can search you?
Oh, you're so quick, Kelly.
Not unless you help me get rid of old Dobson. We had a deal, remember?
He is no threat to you.
I want him out, and I want you to make sure of it. It's the only way I'll help you get Kean. Just how bad do you want it, Miss Ferguson?
Right. You get it right this afternoon. See what I can do.
What's the village? Oh, it's so hard to believe all those dreadful things I've heard, you know. I mean, she's so beautiful, isn't she? Oh, can't you just picture her as a bride?
Oh, yes. Probably feed her husband cyanide on the honeymoon.
You should have seen her in the kitchen suck it up to Ray. A real little archangel she was.
Oh, but she's so sweet. You know, she reminds me of someone, but I just can't think of who it is.
I've got an idea she might remind you of yourself, Pixie.
Oh, I hope not. Oh, heavens, you don't think I'm awful, do you?
No, I didn't mean it. You've got to
forget worry, Pixie. You're a real goose's gander.
Should have known better than how bloke always was. Dead moss.
Look, why don't you just forget it? I'm trying to do your way we can make some money.
How?
By getting the girls to bet on different things.
Like what?
Like how many pairs of knickers go through the laundry in a day? I don't know.
Dad, you know
that. Look, I just made $3.50 by standing on my head for 10 minutes. As long as it's something you know you can do or you already know the answer to, you can't lose.
Yeah, but there's no point. We've got nothing to spend our money on.
Rev could get something going. She thought we had some money. And Ray could bring in chockies and ciggies and things.
He would, wouldn't he? Maybe you have got half a brain after all, Rabbit.
Well, the world record attempt has certainly put us in the public eye.
Oh, in a positive way, too. I think it's great what they did for those children.
So do a lot of other people. I've had letters from 15 different companies offering to donate things to the women. Some of them will come in handy, but I don't quite know what I'm going to do with a gross of corn pads. Well, this is the one that'll interest you. One of the big nurseries is offering seedlings.
Vegetables?
Yes, but they're fresh out of aubergines.
Oh, bad luck.
They're dropping them in tomorrow.
I wonder if they'd mind if I went over and picked them up myself after I finish here.
Shouldn't think so.
That way I can have them in time for this afternoon session. Good to get them in straight away if we can.
Yes, all right. Well, I'll give them a call and let them know you're coming.
Oh, thanks, Mrs. Reynolds.
Stan, that dryer you fixed yesterday...
Oh, yes, quite a simple job, really.
Perhaps, but it seems to have broken down again.
It couldn't have. I double-checked it.
Are you sure you didn't miss anything?
Quite sure. A dryer has a mind of its own. I'll have another look at it after I finish here.
Right, Stan.
Hey, you lot, my dad showed me this great match trick this morning. Bet you none of yous can figure
it
out.
Give it a rest, Marlene.
I'll make it worth your while.
Yeah, like fleecing us again.
What, you all chicken or something? Go on, it's real easy.
Oh, I can never work those puzzle things out.
Well, there's a buck in it for the first person that can. And I'll give you 5 minutes to think about it, too.
And what if no one gets it?
You all give me 50 cents. Come on, Myra, be a bit of fun.
Okay, what have we got to do?
Put in your money first, then I'll tell you how it goes.
Right.
Come on.
Yeah, me too.
Better be easy. You've all got to take 9 matches, right?
9.
Make sure you've got 9. 6, 7, 8, 6. Okay.
Okay.
And you've got to turn them into 10.
Oh, that's easy.
Without breaking any.
Yeah, what the mum? Why can't I play?
Well, this is bloody stupid.
Come on, I figured it out.
7, 8. No, you got me. No. Oh.
What?
That'll be a buck, Warren.
Enough bloody hour to figure that out.
Yeah.
Good afternoon, ladies.
Hello, Stan.
Mrs. Reynolds tells me the dryer's broken down again.
Yes, it wouldn't start when we got back from lunch. It was fine this morning.
It should still be. You realise, I hope, that if it breaks down again, I shall have to report suspected sabotage to Mrs. Reynolds.
Come on, Stan, we wouldn't do that to you. Maybe you didn't fix it right the first time.
Shove it, Kelly.
I reckon old Dobson's going to find himself back on the pension before too much longer.
Here are Miss Ferguson. She's all yours.
Yep. Ah, Davies. Stand on the white line.
Miss Ferguson, could I possibly make a phone call to my husband, please?
She's been asking that ever since we left the station. No, I'm sorry. There'll be no phone calls without the governor's say-so. And just stand on the white line.
But if I could just...
Now!
What? Over there, dear.
Now just answer yes or no. Your name is Kerryn Adele Davies, is that correct?
Yes.
You've been sentenced to 2 years imprisonment. The charges being misappropriation of funds and obtaining financial advantage by deception.
God, things are going rugged round here. I just ran into Mrs. Morris in the staff room. She started yelling her head off at me for no reason. I thought she was going to put me on a charge or something.
What for?
Well, she doesn't really need a reason at the moment, does she? She bawled me out or what?
She hasn't been herself lately, that's for sure.
Well, with that bruise she's got on her cheek, no wonder. Must have had an accident. Good, it's nearly as bad as the one I got when I fell in the shower that time.
Which cheek was your bruise on, Sparrow?
Rude bugger.
Reckon we would have heard if she pranged a car or something.
There's no reason you'd want to keep that a secret.
Oh, there's some things you'd want to keep a secret. I know what happened to Mrs. Morris. She went and got herself raped. Silly woman. It made you take notice of me, didn't it?
Stupid little bitches just trying to get attention. Ignore her.
Not too sure about that. Does the stupid little bitch know what she's talking about?
Why ask me? I don't exist, remember?
I think you better tell us everything you know, Angel.
Mrs. Morris, she was raped by a friend of mine.
You set her up. You set her up to be raped.
What's the big deal?
What sort of animal are you?
She's just a screw. What's the matter with all of you?
Maybe you ought to set you up, see how you like it, you rotten bitch.
I'll show you. You're all so high and mighty. I'll get you for what you've done to me.
Mrs. Reynolds, please, it's very important that I get in touch with Lyle, my husband.
Yes, you'll be able to talk to him later, Davies.
But he'll be so worried. He hasn't seen you since...
No, he phoned several times this afternoon to see if you'd arrive, and I've already told him that you have. It's too late for visits now, but he asked me to tell you that he's fine and he'll be in touch with you soon.
Oh, please, if I could just have a few words with him, just to tell him I'm all right.
I've already assured him that you're being looked after. He's got nothing to worry about.
Yes, but have you heard it from me?
He's not available at the moment. He has a business appointment. You'll be able to talk to him tomorrow.
Thank you.
Miss Ferguson's explained the rules to you? Good. Now, you'll be sharing with Pixie Mason. I can't see the two of you having any problems. Any questions you'd like to ask?
This is the first time that Lyle and I have ever been separated.
Well, this one better not be as tricky as the other one.
Just plain old common sense, Doc. Okay, now this guy hires another guy to come and work for him.
Well, what's he working as?
Doesn't matter. And he agrees to pay him one gold bar at the end of 3 days' work. But the worker wants to be paid at the end of each day.
Well, I don't blame him. You can't trust anybody these days.
No. Now, the boss goes along with this, but he's got a problem. You see, you can't cut the gold bar more than once.
Why?
Because you just can't. That's why. Okay, so the boss has figured out finally how to do it. He pays him at the end of each day and everybody's happy.
Well, what's the question?
How do you divide the gold bar into three when you can only cut it into two?
The fuck it if I know.
Give us a piece of paper.
There you go.
What are you folding that for? You can't fold a gold bar.
You can if it's skinny enough.
This one's 4 inches thick, you thickhead. I'll give up.
Well, why didn't he use proper money in the first place? Then he wouldn't have this problem.
It's a trick question, Pixie.
Oh, go on, tell us.
Everybody give up.
Hang on.
Yeah.
Probably. The boss cut off a third and paid him for the first day's work, right? Yeah. Then he took that back as change when he gave him the 2/3 the next day. And then he just gave the last bit to him on the last day.
Good one.
Good, eh?
Well, talk about a bloody trick question.
Yeah, you're a bloody rip-off merchant, Warren.
You're just jealous because you don't know the answers, thickhead.
What do you reckon, Myra?
Sounded fair to me.
Okay, come on, everybody. Cough up. 26.
Come on.
Hey, I saw this new chick moving into your dorm today. She was unpacking her stuff.
Did she seem like a nice person?
I don't know. I only saw her back.
Well, I think I might just go and see how she's settling in, eh?
Yeah.
Yes, get a few goodies out of her, eh?
Come on, you lot. Garden detail. Move it out.
Well, I think I might go and get a cardie. Hello, love. Just thought I'd come and see how you're settling in.
Hello, are you Pixie?
Nah, Dot Farrah's the name. I'm what you might call the oldest inhabitable, so I make it my job to come and welcome people.
Oh.
Got a name, have you?
Kerryn Davies.
Oh, in for long?
2 years.
Oh, God, you poor kid. 2 years can seem like 10 in here.
Yes, although I have been told that it's not that bad.
Who told you that? Oh, sorry, love, but it's best you get the bad news over first. Mind you, there's precious little good news in here.
Dot, do most of the women in here have husbands and families?
Some of them, yeah.
Must miss them.
I suppose they do. Mind you, some of them are in here for doing their hubbies in. Got everything put away, have you? Best not to leave anything lying around, especially biscuits. Someone nicked all mine. Give me soul for a biscuit, I would.
Oh, well, I'm sorry, Dot, but I haven't got anything like that.
Oh, well, never mind. See you at dinner, eh? Mind you bring your anti-acid pills with you.
Oh, God.
All right, ladies, gather round, will you please? Well, I hope you're all wearing your green thumbs.
Oh, no worries, Mr. D.
Now, most of this area has got to be dug over. As you can see, various occupants of this garden have gone to seed.
Yeah, so have some of the people around here.
Except for the silver beet. Mind you, silver beet would survive World War III.
I hate silver beet.
And I want the plots expanded a little.
Doing things on a grand scale, Stan.
Well, with large enough plots, we can produce our own vegetables all the year round.
Lovely. Mm.
Now, when we've got the soil ready, we'll start planting these little fellas. So, let's get to it.
Oh. Okay, girls, hoe in.
Oh, Myra.
Good old Trevor. Now all we've got to do is get him in the ground.
Hey, Doc. Hey, Mum. Are you going outside? Oh, I want some fresh air too, but I'm scared what the other women might do to me.
I would be too if I was you.
Oh, but they wouldn't be like that if they understood. It's just nothing ever went right for me. You always seem to understand, Dot. Maybe you could make them be nicer to me. Oh, honest, Dot, I've been really frightened ever since I told them about Mrs. Morris.
No, bugger you. You're a nasty, malicious little monster. Anybody do a thing like that ought to be hung. Now get out of my way.
You silly old bag.
Yeah, well, I reckon Adams gets everything she deserves.
Sure does, except you wouldn't wish that on your worst enemy.
Mm. Poor Mrs. Zim. Must have been awful for her.
Oh, you two seem to be going great guns. Let's have a look. Oh, you seem to be a bit close together.
Healthy little buggers, eh?
Maybe, but that's some sort of weed. Oh, there's another. It's hard enough keeping weeds down without planting the little devils.
Yeah, well, I'll throw them out for you, Mr. Dobson.
No. You keep up the good work.
I'll fix the bugger.
What do you think this is?
Get
a rice or something?
I just planted those, you bitch!
Hey, Mr. Dobson, Rabbit here's trying to start a fight.
Get off!
Oh, break this up! I never started it.
I don't care who started it. Now clean this up and get inside.
But only just shot here.
You all right, Mr. Dobson?
Yes. I'm sorry, I wasn't much help. You'll be reporting this to Mrs. Reynolds, I suppose.
I'm sorry, but I have to. Kean, I'm going to search you. Why? Because I saw you assault Mr. Dobson.
Go ahead. Waste of time.
On you. Never. Wow. You know what being caught with a weapon means, Kean? It means solitary. And there, you'll be on your own.
Do you have anything to say, Kean?
Plenty. But I'd be wasting my time, wouldn't I?
Why were you carrying a knife?
You never know when some bastard's going to come sneaking up behind you.
That's enough. Well, you know the punishment, Kean. 24 hours in solitary. Wait outside with Miss Brown.
Well, you heard.
Why did you let things go as far as they did? You should have been in there at the first sign of trouble.
Thought they were just horsing around until I saw Kean assault Mr. Dobson.
Was he aware of what was going on?
Oh, it all happened so quickly.
All right, take Kean up to solitary and make out a report on the incident as soon as you can.
Have it on your desk within the hour.
Tomorrow morning will be fine, thank you.
Oh, my God.
Just saw the freak marching Reb off to... Where's Jude?
Bloody months I've been working on that.
Oh, Dot. Was a work of art too. What happened?
I don't know.
that I've got a bloody good guess, that rotten little monster.
Angel.
Angel. A bloody devil, that's what she is. It's ruined.
Why are we going on the back way?
Patience, Kean. Come on. Can't put off the inevitable forever, can we?
I don't understand how it happened. One minute they're all working there happily, and the next...
It's frightening the way ugly situations just come out of the blue like that.
I seem to have got off to a pretty bad start, don't I?
The bad days do tend to outnumber the good ones here, Stan. Mm. You're quite sure you still want to cope with that?
You mean, am I up to it? Oh, I'm sure I am. Give me a couple of days and I'll be right back in my stride. Have the place running like clockwork.
I'll take your word for it.
Oh, does that happen to be this morning's paper?
I bring it in from home in the hope that I'll have time to read it. You can have it if you like.
Oh, if you've finished with it, yes. Thanks very much. Perhaps I'd better look up the situation's vacant just in case you do decide to give me the sack.
Dad.
Oh, you nearly gave me your mail as well.
That could be.
Oh, goodbye, Mrs. Reynolds.
What's the matter, Kean? Not looking forward to the little party I've got planned for you?
You're a fool, Ferguson. I don't know what you got in mind, but they'll know it was you.
You got it wrong, Kean. I'm not going to do anything, but you're going to have a little accident.
Oh! Sure. How are you going to explain me having an accident up here?
Easy. You broke away from me. Came up here to try and escape. You might have made it too, but you slipped and fell. Tragic. Long way down, isn't it? Goodbye, Kean.
Oh, no, you don't, Kean! Ah!
Off a bitch. I can't hold on. No. Kean, for God's sake.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again, but that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down, but the sun